Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. Back for another episode. And this episode is part of a series of other episodes that are going to happen on the museums of Goa. Are you aware that in Goa, we have got more than 14 museums? We have got the Goa State Museum. We have got the Central Excise, Customs and Central Excise Museum, Museum of Houses. We have got Goa Chitra, Goa Kruti, Goa Chakra. We have got Saint Tome Museum. Lots of museums there. Museum of Christian Art in Old Goa, the ASI Museum. So in this particular episode, we are going to bring to you the Goa State Museum. But please remember, the building that you see behind me was the earlier museum, but today it has been shifted in transit to the Adil Shah's Palace, and we are going to take you there and show you what is on display and what you are missing if you have not gone to these museums. This particular building was inaugurated on 18th of June 1996. This museum had 14 galleries. Today, you don't get to see 14 galleries, you see a few. But what you see in those few things is amazing. Amazing is not the word for it. Because this museum, it portrays the heritage of our past, the sculptures telling us history from various centuries down the line. They tell us a lot of information about the dynasties that ruled Goa. I think you're missing out something. You must make a point to take your family, your children especially, to these museums, at least one museum a month. And we have got 14, so you can still go across the year. But what you have been missing all this time, I'm going to take you and show it to you. Please accompany me. Let us go from the EDC part of where the old museum building was into the place where it has been placed now. Come on, follow me. So, ladies and gentlemen, from the EDC part of, we have now come into the heart of Panjim City, where we are going to take you to the Goa State Museum. Goa State Museum is presently located in the Adil Shah's Palace. We have shown you the Adil Shah's Palace, and you can see that this is maintained by the Directorate of Museums. Let us not waste more time. Let's go inside and see what they have in store, because this is something that you must come and see over here. This is your treasure. This is my going. Come on. So here we are inside the Goa State Museum. And when you come here, you are met by two young and very smart security guards. And do you know why you require security guards? Because everything that has been placed over here is very priceless, and they have a message for you. Now, when you see this, it is very clear. Do not touch any of the objects. So when you come to the museum, don't touch anything. Do not carry eatables. Why is this? It's because if your eatable falls over here, then the rats are going to come and they are going to damage all the woodwork and whatever frames are there. And no smoking. Smoking is bad for health. So either ways, no smoking. So instructions taken. When you come to any museum, you'll follow all this. Good. So now let's walk inside and see. Ha! And by the way, whenever you come here in the museum, see that you don't carry big bags. They are not allowed inside. This cap, you can't wear inside. So I'm going to keep this or deposit this with the security. And
We have been very fortunate to find a young lady, a very smiling lady. Her name is Indira Prabhu Shastri, and she is the senior museum guide. And she is going to take us around and show us what these things are, because just looking at those things doesn't make sense. You have to know the history behind it. So here we are going to meet Indira. Hi, Indira.
Hello, sir.
How are you? She is going to take us and show. See the smile? See. Okay. There you are. Follow us. So, let us see which gallery she is going to take us first. Indira Bhai, can you tell us what gallery you are going to take us?
We are first going to see the gallery Goan Expression Through the Ages.
Okay.
In this gallery, we have different types of inscriptions like stone inscriptions and copper plate inscriptions. Besides that, we also have different sculptures which can be categorized into Hindu, Buddhist and Jain.
You mean to say that we had Buddhists and Jain besides Hindus here?
Yes.
So we can still see the same.
Yes.
What is this?
That is a stone inscription.
Okay.
Generally, it is known as Gadyaga.
Gadyaga.
Yeah.
Okay.
It is a proclamation wherein the king tells us that you should do this, this, this. And if it is not done, then the person will be punished in a very similar.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, look at how that interpretation is. On top, you see a linga. And you see the sun and the moon. Telling you that in the presence of God, until the sun and the moon exist, I am going to give this, 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 with this particular things that have to be done by that person. And if you don't do that, then you will be severely punished. This grant has got a gadyaga. Keep that in mind. Next time you promise that you are going to do something, do it. Otherwise, remember the word gadyaga. Okay, now, you know, we see a lot of sculptures over here, this grants and all. But I see a very lovely statue over there. What is that statue?
The statue is of Gopinath from Netravali, which is close to the Budbudachi Thori.
Is this the temple that is next to the Budbudachi Thori?
Yes.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, remember one thing, that when you come here, all these things have been brought from different places all over Goa. And that particular idol was next to a lake, a temple lake, which keeps on bubbling. They say that if you clap, more bubbles come, or if you say Om Namah Shivaya, it comes. But the point is, I have noticed, I got my hands red, but the bubbles came when they wanted to come. But it is worth going and seeing it. It's a little bit far away from here. It's about 70 kilometers from here. But go there and see it. And this Murti of Gopinath comes from there. Let's go into the next. What is this Mahavir? Is this the Buddhist and the Jain thing that you are telling?
Yes.
Okay.
This is a statue of Buddha, seated Buddha in Bhumisparsh Mudra. This was brought from Riuna.
Okay.
The caves are famous as Buddhist caves.
Ah, so again, ladies and gentlemen, this particular Buddha statue has been brought from a place where, if you go, you can find the Riuna cave. And this particular statue was found in the fields opposite to that cave. See, you get more information by just coming over here. So if you are going to visit Goa, please come over here. I'm going to show you something else, something very beautifully carved. Indira Bhai, I see a big sculpture over here. What is this about?
This is the sculpture of Gajalakshmi. When Goddess Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, is flanked by elephants, showering her with water, and pictures are generally shown, it is known as the Gajalakshmi.
Gajalakshmi.
Now, this sculpture is a panel showing the different day-to-day activities of the villagers.
Oh, so that is what the carvings are all about.
Yes.
Okay. And what about this lions over here?
The Kadambas had their symbol as lions with an upright right paw.
Okay. So, in other words, when you see such a thing, it does not necessarily mean that it is during the Kadam time. It may be influenced by the Kadams. Keep that in mind. Okay. We can see something else here.
This is a sculpture of Chaturmukhi Shiva, and it shows the different emotions of the humans. That is, one emotion is calm and serene, the other one is ferocious, a third one is feminine, and the fourth one is unaffected by the pleasures of the world. That on the top you can see the river Ganga is shown in a personified way.
And this is the Nandi. Indrabai, I see some stone slabs here, but you know there are carvings that are different here and over here. What are these stones here?
These are called as the memorial stones.
Memorial.
These are the hero stones, these are the sati stones.
Okay.
They were erected in memory of a person who sacrificed his life for the society.
Okay.
And the lady who went the sati.
Ladies and gentlemen, just for your information, when there was an act of bravery and somebody died in battle, or a brave man died, when they gave him the final rites, they erected the stones, and these are called as the hero stones. But we also had a very horrendous tradition over here called as the sati, which was stopped by Afonso Albuquerque when he came here on the Tiswadi island, but was going around on the outside. And later on, Raja Ram Mohan Roy took a stand, and all over India sati was banned. So when you come to museums or you see them out in the hills somewhere, please bring it to our notice. You'll always find a pillar, a hand, and a depiction. And you have the sun and the moon over here, and the ling over here. So next time, ladies and gentlemen, remember when you see this, that a person was burnt alive on the pyre. Very horrendous. Let's not do this. Now let's see where Indra is going to take us into the next gallery. Indrabai, what is this? Is this that copper plate?
Yes, this is the copper plate of the Kadamba king Veerwarmadev.
Okay. And what does this grant?
It is a land grant to a Brahmin.
Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, you have heard of copper plates and you have heard of this and that. Now you can see an actual copper plate, and if you see it very carefully, it has got three copper plates, rectangular, with a ring which is sealed. Now they have opened it out, and it has the seal of that royalty on the side. So let us find out from Indrabai where you are going to take us in, which other gallery are you going to take?
The next gallery is the Portuguese phase. There you are going to see the different antiquities which are from the Portuguese period. This is a sofa with ivory inlay.
Okay, so what we see there is,
yes,
ivory. And what is that behind?
That is a chest of drawers with coconut shell inlay.
Coconut shell inlay. And what was this chest holding? Some treasures?
When we got it, it was full of documents.
Oh, very nice, very nice. When you come here, you know, please keep an eye on these small things which are there. We have got idols over here, we have got furniture over here, so many things. Let us see what more things are there. I see some chairs over there. Let's go and see what the chairs are. Okay, whose is this chair?
This chair belongs to the judge of High Court.
Of the Portuguese, during the Portuguese era.
During the Portuguese.
Okay, and this one over here?
This is the chair of the chairman of Santa Casa de Misericordia.
Okay, so today when we look at the GIM or the,
yes,
old medical,
yes,
college at Ribandar,
yes,
it has got Casa Santa written on. So that was the place.
That was the place.
Okay, and what about this chair?
This chair is the chair of the headmaster of Lyceum.
And Indrabai, what is this?
This is the first available printing press from Goa.
Okay.
Printing was started in the year 1556.
Okay.
But this dates to a much later period, that is 1860.
This actually is a piece of 1860. But the printing, the first printing press in Asia was in Goa in the College of St. Paul in Old Goa, started in 1556. And just for your information, it was not supposed to come over here. They had come from Portugal to take it to Ethiopia. But when they came into that Suez area, the Mediterranean, they were told that there is a war going on. So they proceeded with that over here. And when the priests over here came to know that there was a printing press, they pursued those people to leave it here and go. See how lucky we were? Okay, now there is something else that I want Indira Bai to tell us, and that is this banner. There is a lovely banner here with gold brocaded and or zari, what we call as, and it has got ivory inlay.
This is the Portuguese victory flag, handmade by the nuns of Santa Monica. This dates to 1638.
Okay. And ladies and gentlemen, just for your information, when I had gone to the Museum of Christian Art, the curator there told me that this is a unique handicraft that is on a velvet cloth with zari. They had ivory pieces inlaid. And here you can see them, the Jesus Christ and the faces of the people. They are all in ivory.
Now we are going in the Goa's Freedom Struggle Gallery. But sir, I would like to show you a very beautiful piece. These are the lottery draw machines. They were brought by the Portuguese in the year 1947. Each machine had 50,000 balls. Okay. Each ball has a number. By rolling these machines, they used to release a ball wherein the number was declared as the winning lottery.
Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, you can see they are cork balls, each having a number, and they would roll this big cage and mix the ball, and they would release only one numbered ball into the container, and that was the winning ticket. See, very impartial way. If only we could do a lot of selection and election process this way. Beautiful.
This gallery showcases the Goa struggle for freedom. That is the freedom fighters who lost their lives, who struggled for the freedom of Goa, as well as the different satyagrahas.
Ladies and gentlemen, you all know that 19th of December 1961, Goa was liberated from the Portuguese rule by Operation Vijay, which was led by Major General Kunniraman Palat Kendeth. And the surrender treaty or the instrument of surrender was signed at 8:30 at night on 19th of December 1961 at Vasco. And the road in front of that today is called as Swatantrapath. But the journey of liberation, we had to pay a lot of price. It all started much, much earlier with Dipaji Rane here, Dada Rane and his band of people here. And then we had the 18 June 1946, the uprising, the revolt by Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia in Margaon, which inspired people to take Satyagraha. And on 15th August 1954, the call was given to volunteer. Almost 20-25,000 people volunteered. And on 15th August, because India got freedom on 15th August. As soon as the unarmed Satyagrahis entered Goa, the Portuguese opened machine gun fire on them. 22 people were killed. Today we have a huge memorial at Patradevi, but we should not forget their sacrifices. Here you can see those people who were shot on that day being brought out by the two foreign correspondents. People were fallen all over the place. Indians were not allowed to go in, but these foreigners carried them out and brought them from Patradevi into Banda. Here you can see a section where the Portuguese soldiers are made to sit on Azad Maidan. They have destroyed the Banastari Bridge, and the Indian sappers are putting up another bridge here. And the officers, this photograph was of the morning of 19th December 1961. You can see the last Governor General Manuel Antonio Vassal da Silva sitting in the middle. The gentleman with the white hair is General Thapar, and they are discussing the terms of surrender. And the last panel over here shows the commanding officer Kunninaman Palat Kandath, or KP Kandath, Major General KP Kandath over here. And then in the evening, the salute was taken in front of the secretariat. And just for your information, this is the Treaty of Surrender, the actual Treaty of Surrender, not the original, but a facsimile of that particular copy, which is written in English, in Portuguese, signed by Manuel Antonio Vassal da Silva. It is translated in English. The two witnesses here, the battle order, means all the battalions that took part in that, and on the side it is written, accepted by Brigadier Dhillon. So Goa has got liberation through sacrifices of many. We cannot take our Goa for granted. So please, we have got so much of heritage over here. It needs your participation. So please, come around and see this. Okay, now let's see what Indira Bai has to show us. Another gallery over here. So Indira Bai has brought us to see a gallery which they say glimpses of the Goan culture. Over to Indira Bai.
When we enter this gallery, we first see the sculpture of Padmanabh. This is a very beautiful sculpture dating to the Kadamba period.
Okay.
Then we see the beautiful temple pillars.
Okay, these are all wooden pillars, carved wooden pillars. How old should this be?
These are about 200 to 300 years old.
200 years to 300 years old. And is this the way that the Goans dressed?
Yes, this is the way the old Goans dressed.
Okay, the earlier. Ethnic wear, ethnic. We can say. And here we see a palki. This is the palanquin, a religious palanquin, which was used in temples during the festival. Now this is called as palki, and we have another palanquin which is called as the lalki. Let us see that. This is the lalki. Now there is one difference I will tell you. In the palki, the deity is placed at the back, resting at the back of the palanquin, while in a lalki it is put in the middle over here, not at the back. In this gallery, you know, when we are going from this palki to lalki, we find that there are a lot of lamps that are used during the Hindu rituals. Each has got a name. It is called a Kaipunchi, Niranjan, Pancharati, Pancharati, Ekarati. It's quite a lot of things. So please come here and see this. And there is the utensils that are also used in the rituals. But what I want to know from Indira Bai is about this tulsi. And incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, your cameraman is also Tulsidas. So we call him Tulsi. So let's talk about him now.
This is a Tulsi Vrindavan. You will find these types of Tulsi Vrindavans in front of Hindu houses where the Tulsi is planted. This is a special vase for the Tulsi. And this piece was done by Vishnu Kugalkar. It is a terracotta piece dating to 1930.
These are the 3-4 galleries that we have found here, but what I want you all to see is the museum week is going on, and the Goa State Museum has put up an exhibition of the mansions or the big ancestral houses that have been here in Goa. You must come here and see that, because those houses are amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, you just can't get more information anywhere else. Come to the Goa State Museum. They have preserved all these things just for you, especially your children. You are in Panjim, you have time, you don't know what to do. Come here, just walk around, and I can tell you, these places were built to feel cool. So if you're feeling hot outside, walk in here. So what we will do now is we will say thanks to Indira Bai, and let's hope for the next episode. So Indrabai, thank you very much for your effort, and we are very thankful that you have preserved all this here for people to come and see. One last question for you. When is this museum open?
This is open from Monday to Friday at from 9:30 to 5:30 p.m.
So ladies and gentlemen, between the visits to the three, four galleries that are over here, we found a little time to sneak into the cabin of the director of this museum, Mrs. Bhave. Ma'am, thank you very much for allowing us to cover your museum and take it to the people. I'm sure you have got a message for the people.
You are always welcome, dear people of Goa. I would like to request you to visit this museum, and my sincere appeal is to contribute to the enrichment of this museum by donating or parting with your valuable objects which reflect Goan history, culture and Goan lifestyle. This is your museum, and I feel you all should visit here, view our display, and also help and guide us in protecting our cultural heritage of Goa.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Bhave. I think you have given a beautiful message. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, please make it a point. If any school teacher or a principal or a headmaster is seeing this, make it a point. Put it in your itinerary to bring your children over here, because they are going to be the custodians of our heritage in the years to come. Thank you. So ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of this episode, which is in the State Museum, the Goa State Museum. And you know exactly what are the beautiful things that are over here. Just for your information, all this is just one fraction of what they were displaying at the old museum. This is just a temporary phase. I'm sure that you have got something to tell us. There are things in Goa that we may not be about and which you want us to come and cover. Please write to us on the email that you see over here. Ladies and gentlemen, all these things in Goa, we have about 14 museums. And if we don't go and patronize all this, we have got Goa Chitra, the Goa Kruti and Goa Chakra in Benavli. We have got San Tome, which we have brought you as an episode. We have got the Museum of Houses. We have got the Museum of Christian Art. We have got the Archaeological Survey of India Museum. There is the Customs and Central Excise Museum. There is the Museum of Goa. So many museums, and we are trying our best to get this for you. And in this particular episode, if you find that there is something that you want to tell us, again, let me remind you, write on the email that you see over here so that we can get those things for you. So, ladies and gentlemen, at this stage, let me say bye-bye to you and signing off. Let's meet in the next episode.